Seguimos en el Mobile World Congress, estamos haciendo la cobertura de todo lo que sucede en el Congreso, invitando a tantas compañías como podemos acomodar en el horario de videoproducción y esperemos que sean el máximo posibles. Y nos acompaña ahora Scott Bamer, que es vicepresidente de ventas para las Américas de una empresa que se llama Seven Networks. Welcome to Telesemana.
Thank you.
First thing we need to know is who Seven Networks is, because we haven't heard from your company before.
Okay.
I don't know if our audience in Latin America, they know you, I don't know if you know them. Yes. So this is a good time to introduce you to them and then to know you.
Excellent. So Seven is a company that was founded in 2000. We focused on a flagship product of mobile email. So we were one of the first companies to do true push email.
Okay.
And from that, the core services and technology actually translate very well into an overall push architecture. And so as companies started to look at the capabilities we had, partners and OEM, Seven actually became known for our push technology, being able to take information from a source and bring it to the handset in a timely manner and make sure that everything was done both at the handset and in the middleware at the same time.
Okay. Now, just mentioning email, you know, when somebody tells me about email, you know which company comes to mind?
Sure.
Can I mention it? Or?
Sure.
Yeah, it's BlackBerry.
Yeah.
He's carrying one. I don't. I have an iPhone. So tell me, you know, what companies can bring to the operators, because it seems that they have tried the email service in the past and they end up going with room for that. So
yeah, so it's a unique challenge, right? Because there's an inherent understanding from users that they want BlackBerry, right? But what they love about BlackBerry is the immediacy, the push, right? The mm-hmm. feeling that you always have your real-time information. What's unique about what Seven offers is we do great push technology. It's what our whole service is founded on. But Seven has some other characteristics in our sync protocols that give carriers and OEMs an advantage in the sense that imagine a scenario where BlackBerry is a very closed platform designed for their devices and their services.
Yep.
Imagine you could take those efficiencies to other devices and other platforms, so Android, J2ME, Brew, Symbian, right? So now suddenly across your whole portfolio you have the ability to have push, real time, and also network efficiencies, because what's happening out there is applications are being developed, but they're being developed by developers who don't understand mobile technology. And Seven is ingrained in mobile. That's how we made our offerings to start from the very beginning.
Yep.
And we're very efficient. So imagine efficiencies of 60, 70, 80% on email transfer. And even if it's the number 5 or 6 challenge that carriers face from the amount of traffic coming through,
mm-hmm.
Being able to save 50 megs a month is a huge deal from a network transparency and capability perspective.
So actually your technology kind of compresses the data.
That's right.
Okay. Now let me tell you something, and you can say if it's true or not.
Okay.
From your perspective. One of the things that operators complain off the record,
okay,
is that their Node Bs are being bombarded with these push technologies, making the handset and the Node B being connected, disconnected, connected, disconnected, connected,
exactly,
disconnected. And apparently that's not good for the network. It's challenging. So tell us, you know, how can that be avoided, if it can be avoided, in a way that the user still gets those push notifications, but that doesn't mean that the handset needs to be connecting and disconnecting with the node bits all the time.
That's right. One of the challenges out there is the nomenclature of push has been generalized. So there's a lot of folks who say they do push, but it's not true push.
Okay.
What happens is there's even ActiveSync is a protocol that has some push from a server-side capability, but most of it is based off of client polling. So imagine a scenario where handset clients wake up and go ask for information, even if it's not valid or if the timing nothing has changed on the backside.
Okay.
So that's what carriers are faced with. They now have not only email applications, but they've got applications from other partners that Facebook, SNS, right, all these
or
things.
Twitter. Or,
that's yeah. right. Constantly actually asking for information as well as trying to receive information.
Yeah. Even though there's no information whatsoever.
Exactly. So Seven has got a layer of intelligence both at the client and the middleware layer where we can actually manage that interaction. And in fact, we're here not only talking about email capabilities and messaging, but we're here to talk at Mobile World Congress about our open channel capability, which takes this to the next level, being able to give carriers a way to manage all applications at the handset.
Okay, well, because actually you mentioned that you were based with email, but now you're saying that you are kind of a push.
That's right.
Any type of service.
That's exactly right.
Although we concentrated first on email.
Correct.
Okay. So let's go for the push market.
Okay.
Tell us how that has changed in the past few years, and given the fact that you're saying that everything now seems to have the tag of being pushed,
right?
Where is this going?
So the market's changed dramatically. You summed it up really well. Almost every application developer now, whether it be about your financial information, your email, SNS, they all want to say that they push the technology to the handset because the change from a poll method, right, of users would wake up and look in a browser and go find what they want.
Yep.
The concept now is that every user wants things natively on the handset. So I pick up my handset, I open it up, and everything has been refreshed for me. Well, that creates a challenge for the developer. They now have to figure out how to get all this information down to the handset. And there are some channels occurring. Apple has push now, right? Google has done some push. But the challenge is those are all focused on specific channels, right? And they don't offer the efficiencies on the backside. They're not designed in mind with the carrier.
So the operator pays the price.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right. So, and so 7 is focused on how we can create both a handset and a platform in the middle that is more focused on how operators and OEMs can optimize those channels. And it's proving in our trials to be very, very efficient, up to 70% efficiency.
Okay, so you are kind of a vaccine for the harm that pushes creates to the operator.
That's right.
That would be kind of a
yeah.
No, we are the vaccine.
That's right. So we're a white label company. We're a plumbing company. Okay. We do great. We have UIs and reference UIs, right?
But don't say you're a plumbing company because we're talking about the downpipe and you're the plumber. And you know, it's,
no. So we're giving that intelligence back to those pipes, right? To say what is really important, how should it be pushed, and what should be done. Now, what 7's focused on that's very unique, though, is there's lots of people who say that they optimize either web traffic or streaming. This is more about how do you manage both bandwidth and signaling. So people can optimize bandwidth, but one of the major challenges that you just pointed out is all the wake up, right? Yep. To applications talking back to the network when there's not a need for that. And if 7 can help carriers optimize that like we do through Open Channel, there's both OpEx and CapEx savings for them on the bandwidth and optimization side.
Which actually just, you know, if you switch it at 10 p.m. at night and turn it on at 8 a.m., that would be just a smart move. A simple one, no?
It's
make sure
one.
That push is not.
That's right. And
functional.
You'll actually, if you see a 7 client, you'd notice that we have quiet time settings built in.
Okay.
But that is one subset of the problem that they're faced, right? Because most of the traffic, most of that activity is during a certain point of the day, and that's what operators need help managing.
Yeah. Correct. Not collapsing the network.
That's right.
All right, that's pretty clear. So thank you so much for stopping by and give us an update on, or at least an explanation on who 7 is. I think that's pretty much very clear now. And we look forward to seeing you again at CTIA or other shows.
All right, thank you very much.
Thanks.
All right.